Hello there, and welcome to the first Why You're Bad special episode. This episode will not be as usual, meaning a video in which I try to teach you tips and tricks to help you becoming better at the game. This special episode will be more like a discussion on a topic which is highly important for War Thunder, and yet so few people know or understand what it really is. Without further ado, let's get to it. Why You're Bad special. Situational awareness. In my opinion, situational awareness is the most important skill to develop in War Thunder because it can give you a ludicrous amount of skills in a game and save your life big time. So, first thing first, let's define what situational awareness is. If you're subscribed to Napalmrata's channel, and if you're not, I highly suggest you to, otherwise what are you doing with your life? You know that he talks a lot about situational awareness and how important this skill is to War Thunder. That's because Napalmrata is a very experienced player and he knows what he's talking about. And he's right. I too have quite a playtime on War Thunder and I can't recall all the times where my situational awareness rewarded me one way or another in my games. The gameplay you'll be seeing in the background is basically me in a real game applying everything I will explain in this video. That's why I left the markers on, unlike as usual. So, what is situational awareness? If you follow this series, or at least if you watched my previous video, you might have noticed that every topic was about the mechanic of War Thunder that allow you to spot targets, to hear your targets, but also to help you locate yourself or your enemies on the map. To put it very simply, situational awareness is the combination of these four skills I talked about in my videos. It is the ability and state of mind of a player that allow him to exactly know what is going on around him. Since I already made a video on each separate skill, I won't talk about them in details here, but rather from the point of view of the bigger picture. So if you did not see my videos, I can only suggest you or even advise you to go and check them. I'll leave a link of the playlist in the description. Sadly, situational awareness is not a magical technique that you can learn by watching videos or by practicing a specific drill. It's all about experience and especially discipline. Discipline is the key word here. Let me explain. Imagine that you're on Alaska, just as I am right now. You're in your favorite tank ever, the one you love the most and you'll perform the best in. Everyone in the game is now spawned in and you are behind cover, thinking about what to do next. Any random player would think, the way is open, no one is to be seen, so let's press W and see what happens. Of course, it works. Sometimes. Because most of the times, the second you will cross a road or pass a corner, you can bet that the most experienced player will be waiting here for you. So, what do you do to think and process the game that you're playing? First of all, look at your minimap. The position of your team is very often telling of something more important, the position of the enemy team. If your team is there, then you know the enemy team must be in this zone, otherwise you would see markers or hear fights. If you're behind a ridge line, you can scan with your binoculars to see, safe and unharmed, if there is anyone hidden behind a rock ready to pounce on the first target that would cross his sight. Finally, you can just sit where you are and listen for gunshots, engine sounds, or any sound cues that could help you knowing how the game is progressing. And all of this without even moving from your cover. If you're a more visual person and really want something to remember in order for you to practice, in quotes, your situational awareness, I can give you this. Let's imagine that every time you want to do something in War Thunder, like moving somewhere, to go cap a point, to join a teammate for help, or anything, you'll have to go through a protocol, which we'll call the awareness protocol. The protocol would be this: minimap, sound, bino, eyes. MSBE. At first, you might take some seconds to do this thoroughly, but don't worry, the more you do it, the faster it will become second nature, and you won't have to think about it anymore. Of course, the more you do it in-game, the more you'll be safe, since you're constantly looking for clues around you, because you can go through the protocol while you're hidden behind cover, but you can do it every time that you're not fighting, or when you're moving somewhere, or just because you have nothing else to do at the moment. This simple protocol to follow can really help you, and I really mean it. But don't think that it will make you invulnerable or unkillable, because, let's face it, sometimes you can be the best player around, you might just be unlucky. Luck, or even RNG, can be a really big part of War Thunder sometimes, and even be the reason of why you lived or died. You just have to acknowledge it and accept it. You can't win them all, and you can't carry all games. Furthermore, do not hesitate to rewatch your bad games thanks to the replay mode. Try to understand why you were killed at a specific moment. Why did the enemy had the advantage over you? Or why did you waste your advantage and got killed because of it? There is no shame in trying to get better, but it is quite shameful to revel in mediocrity. As a teacher of mine once told me, one must not add to failure the mistake of not learning a lesson from it. In other words, if you perform poorly, it is up to you to stand up and fix the problem. Trust me, my friends, there is nothing in this world that can't be beaten by work and dedication. As this episode is approaching its end, I would just add this. Situational awareness is key and important to War Thunder, because it comes from your experience of the game, of the maps, etc. But another big factor is how you know your tank, which is precisely the main theme of the following videos of the series. Didn't see that coming, did ya? Anyway, I hope you liked this special episode. It was a first try for me, and I really enjoyed making it. So feel free to leave a comment to tell me what you thought about it or how I could have improved it if need be. So finally, be safe, my friends, keep getting better, and I'll see you in the next one.